Adobe Max just ended, and Photoshop has some key new features. First is the removal tool, which has a new one-click remove distractions button. We have a new generative workspace, bringing Firefly image generation right into Photoshop with some nice quality of life features. And finally, the adjustment brush tool, which really helps streamline the process of making pinpoint adjustments. Making Photoshop more user-friendly and intuitive still seems to be at the top of Adobe's priority list for Photoshop. So let's take a closer look at some of the bigger updates for Photoshop from Adobe Max. First, we have some pretty big improvements to the Remove tool, mainly a one-click Find Distractions button in the upper options bar here. We can choose either wire and cables or people. Wires and cables work really, really well even on more complex images, with overlapping objects or lots of detail. I was very impressed. And the Find People option works just the same. It'll look for any people it thinks are not the subject of the photo and remove them. It'll highlight the people first it intends to remove, and then you click to confirm that removal. It doesn't do as good of a job knowing who it should remove, seemingly erring on the side of caution so it doesn't accidentally remove the main subject. But it's still a big time saver, especially for things like beaches, city streets, and other public locations. A great addition. Next, we have the new generative workspace, which is in the beta version of Photoshop, but I still want to touch on it. You can download the beta version of Photoshop, by the way, from the Creative Cloud app. If you have Photoshop, you can get the beta version. So generative workspace brings Adobe Firefly image generation into Photoshop with some, like I said, quality of life features. If you are someone who generates a lot of images, you can now run multiple prompts at once. No more waiting on one to finish and then doing another. Everything now generates in the background. You can favorite, search, and reuse the previously generated images, building up your own archive, essentially. This will come in very handy because you can now use a single prompt to generate multiple concepts at once using variables. So typing red, yellow, and blue studio background, marking that line of text as a variable with brackets or the add variable button, and then separating each color with a comma will generate 3 variations of each listed color or whatever your variable is. You'll see how many variations will be generated next to the generate button right here. Now, Adobe claims this is all commercial use safe. However, I always highly recommend looking into all of the ethical implications to get the full scope when it comes to AI. This video is brought to you by Envato, unlimited creative assets and the broadest range of categories, all in one place. Follow the link in the description and start creating now. And finally, we have the adjustment brush, which is a nice little addition, I think. Now, instead of creating an adjustment layer, then a selection, and then masking, the adjustment brush wraps all 3 steps into one easy-to-use brush tool. First, choose your adjustment in the upper options bar here. Next, you can either manually brush or choose object select. I'm going to choose object select. And then we can click to create the adjustment layer, mask and all. Now, this adjustment layer is just a normal layer and mask that you can edit, adjust, move, delete, of course, all the good stuff. The brush is just there to streamline and simplify a very common workflow. It's a great addition, especially for new users. If you have a favorite update, however, I'd love to hear it below. Or maybe an announcement and update you weren't too happy about. I really love hearing those. And you can always put these updates to use by checking out some of the other videos that Envato Tech Plus has to offer. If you like this video, consider giving us a like and even subscribing if you still need to. And remember to click the little bell icon to be notified of all new videos, including tips, tricks, and of course, tutorials. Happy designing! See you next time!